honor graduates, and we do it for our four-year traditional graduates in a minute. And this is the second of three ceremonies that will be held in the theater today. I'm Dr. Paula Dempsey-Keller, Dean of Nursing, and you might want to keep those back doors open and all for air, just slightly. I'll leave that to the IT people, maybe better to do. It's a privilege to have all of your wonderful family and friends here, our esteemed faculty and staff. Administration sends their hearty regards and congratulations, as today is the Board of Trustees meeting, and they're busy looking at our new school of nursing, which hopefully we will be digging ground soon for. You might have seen the renderings in the School of Nursing already, so as soon as you get out of here, you're going to want to get a job, take your boards, or take your boards, get a job, come back, and go through our post-baccalaureate doctor of nursing practice, get your master's, you know, either educator or nurse practitioner track. We plan on seeing a lot of you in our modern building as well. So we hope the Board of Trustees is doing good work out there, because we know the plans are all set and the land has been purchased and we're meeting with the architects and it is pretty spectacular. So maybe we'll have a different home when you return. But we've done very well in the current home, and I think as a center of excellence, you guys have enjoyed a good tenure here, and we appreciate all of your contributions to the community and to the school while you're here, and wish you so well on your journey. So, with that said, and over a million nurses retiring, such as myself, in the next 5 years throughout the United States, it's kind of nice to know you'll be one of those graduates who has a job waiting, and an important one it is. So I'm going to have Reverend Morgan come up, like he did for our white coat ceremony for the nurse practitioners, and offer you some wise words and some spirituality and thoughtful thinking for our audience. Reverend Martin is the college's chaplain. Come on up.
Thank you, Dr. Trapello. Welcome, it's a pleasure to be able to be here today. As Dean Trapello was saying earlier, in just a few hours, there will be a baccalaureate service in this space, and we will hear words from the story of Abraham, in which signs of faithfulness are more numerous than one can count in the sky. We'll also hear from astronomer and scientist Carl Sagan, what he literally says about the cosmos and the stars of the Earth. You are here. Graduates, you are here. Family and friends, you are here as well, and our graduates would not be here today without your support. We want to give thanks for the support, for the family that you have become to them, for the friends that you are to them, and we want to give thanks for the hard work that these graduates have put in as they embark and look forward to a career. We also want to look forward and give thanks for the lives that they will touch. One of our professors, Professor Tourney, has a blessing that she often uses with her nursing students. It's called the blessing of the hands. And I would like to offer that blessing to our graduates today, as well as to your family and friends, because you will have hands and hearts that will touch you. Blessed be these hands that have touched my heart. Blessed be these hands that have felt pain. Blessed be these hands that have embraced with compassion. Blessed be these hands that have clenched with anger or withdrawn in fear. Blessed be these hands that have drawn blood and administered medicine. Blessed be these hands that have cleaned beds and disposed of waste. Blessed be these hands that have anointed the sick and offered blessings. Blessed be these hands that grow stiff with age. Blessed be these hands that have comforted the dying and held the dead. Blessed be these hands. We hold the future in them. Blessed be our hands. For they are your hands, O Holy One. Amen. Amen.
Thank you so much, Reverend Martin, who, along with our staff and senior faculty had a lot to do with preparing this room and having a beautiful back screen for us. We'd also like to thank Ed, our guitarist, who is doing double duty today, two ceremonies in a row. Teaches in the music department at the college, and we'd also like to thank our wonderful media group, Lee Manchester. Some of you always remark, gee, I finally learned when I'm graduating who Lee is, because he does all the announcements, but he provides his department, as you can see, provides not only live video of your ceremony, so you can watch yourself on YouTube, but we'll also make available. So those of you in the audience know, you do not have to worry about getting a picture of Penny. We have a young woman who will be doing nothing but that, an actual portrait of each and every person we can, and it will be made available to you
by Tuesday.
By Tuesday, electronically. So it will be a very nice gift, I think, that you'll be able to use. And then we also, after the ceremony, will be asking you to march out to the front steps, where you will get a group photo that you'll also have access to, and you'll also see in the halls of the Evelyn L. Spiro School of Nursing in a frame. So at this point, I'd like to call up our first student speaker, Tyler Wilcox.
Now, normally I don't get nervous at all when I have to talk in front of people because they're all well aware I can talk and talk and talk for days. But you're all pretty intimidating. So just to let you know, I'm extremely tachycardic at the moment. A little tachypnic, diaphoretic, and I'm wearing white. So that would be great. I'm very syncopal, but none of you have any idea what that means, don't fret. I mean, know exactly what I said and know what to do if I hit the ground. Let me first start off by saying that I'm humbled and I'm honored to sit among a group of people who are not allowed to be the best nurses in their field, but a group of men and women who embody the true values of nursing, and that is dedication, generosity, perseverance, humor, and we don't like that one bit. In fact, it's probably our humor that got us through these tough years. The list of qualities can honestly go on and on, but without a doubt, the energy and charisma of this class is almost tangible, as this afternoon we all come together to celebrate our completion of what we thought was some of the hardest years of our lives. But let us also celebrate the accumulation of knowledge and experience we never imagined we could possess before beginning our studies here at Wagner. So here we are. I'm pretty sure it's safe to say we've reached the end of this road, and so I think it's only fitting that we let the beginning laugh a little bit. We all remember the T's, right? For those who don't know, the T's pretty much stand for the test of essential academic skills that we need to pass in order to get into nursing school. So in essence, it's another mini-anxiety attack before we even get into nursing school. But I remember when we passed that test, it was all good and all. You know, we saw proficient, we passed, we got in. But now we needed the letter. We needed that letter. And I remember every day in my bathroom brushing my teeth and we'd watch my mailman come down the road. And I would see him and I'd be like, oh, I'm gonna get that letter. And I went outside, I'd go get bathrobe and all, you mean, I was out there, I was getting that letter. And every day, no Tyler, not today. No Tyler, not today. Finally, the day came. And I'm pretty sure we all got it at the same time because we all took to social media, sharing pictures, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and you name it, the whole world knew we got into nursing school. There was no way you could ignore the numerous updates of our excitement. I mean, we've done it, right? We got into nursing school. Silly, naive. Little did we know what exactly was in store for us, right? First day of orientation was an amateur. I remember the many anxiety attack I had while arriving from my previous slumber, cucumbers and all. But nonetheless, I hopped out of bed and picked out a stylish outfit, of course. I mean, all I knew was I had no idea what I was doing myself into, but I'm sure it was going to look good. I was excited and I was ambitious, and I was ready to soak in every word faculty had to say. I remember being all the way in the back of the lecture hall, I needed a wall, something that would catch me there and fill out. And I remember looking down at the table with all the syllabuses and paperwork, and I thought, oh my gosh, what did I get myself into? And as the day went on, we heard one speech after another, we got more acquainted with the professors, who were all in the front, by the way, and looked fabulous. They were not missing me. And I remember a little manual, it was like a nursing survivor guide. It was cute, like broke it down exactly what to expect. And then here I am, after it hit me, I'm like, you know, I'm a waiter when I'm at home. I can serve people food and snacks. You know, I like planes too. Why do I have to be a flight attendant? I mean, what can I do when I'm around? Why not 30,000 feet? I mean, Delta Airlines never looked so good in my life. But I remember as time went on, and, you know, and as I waited on my customers, some nurses, and I talked to people about, you know, being a nurse, they all told me the same thing, even our professors. And they would always say, nursing is one of the most satisfying professions, and they never regret the day they became a nurse. And that's when it hit me. There's a reason we're all up here and we're doing this. Now, let me just say, you know, nursing is not at all for the weak. And that was made very clear the first day. I mean, when books double the size of encyclopedias for each class, I toughened up and decided, you know, I was going to do whatever it took because I was going to be a nurse. And if that meant spending numerous nights, and I did, in the library, to fix the eyes, hunched over on a cubicle, crying into a med-surg book, and pacing the library, taking deep cleansing breaths, that's so needed because I had to do this and I had to become who I know I was always meant to be. And all of us are meant to be, and that's a nurse. And I can say, you know, we all joke around about how hard it is, and it is. Nursing is something special, is it not? And I have a quote here, and I think Maya Angelou puts it very well. She said, as a nurse, we have the opportunity to heal the heart, mind, soul, and body of our patients, their families, and ourselves. They may not remember your name, but they'll never forget the way they make you. I mean, is that cold natural? Do we not feel it in a clinical setting, or did not PEDS or OB or med surge? Somehow you felt it, and that's when it was doing much more than crying in a textbook here. You know, as time goes on, it gets pretty cool too. You pass those med surge tests, you start acquiring all this knowledge, and it feels good. But it also changes you too. And I don't know if it's me, but some of you start checking out the size of a person's veins ahead of you at the grocery store today. You start noticing conditions just by the way they walk or talk. You think, ooh, sore ankles, that heart condition. Germs. You never become a germaphobe until nursing school gets around. Going to the bathroom, especially public restrooms, it's a project in itself. If you ever saw me, it's like a perfectly orchestrated ballet. I do everything and anything not to touch. I mean, you wash with warm water for a full minute to rub vigorously. Because everything too is infected and everything is beautiful. But we learn not to be too germophobic. But the icing on the cake is, you know, when your friend and family call. That's the best, right? Always right. They call you forever late, pain, sniffle, hang down, chocolate. If you name it, and they expect a full assessment and a full diagnosis. My diagnosis? TMI. So you see, these were our few steps, ladies and gentlemen, and we've indeed come a long way. Our first steps were scary, and at times we were unsteady. Now all those firsts are merely second nature to us. So I suggest that we leave here and embark on a new set of firsts. We remember the first time we embraced our vulnerability. We took on a challenging course of study, and that it was, taking a great deal of determination, persistence, initiative, another quality of my creativity, and sometimes, most of the time, sweat and tears. So embrace that vulnerability. There will always be the fear of the unknown, like the one we felt coming into the program, or worse, what we have learned our patients face. No matter how well we prepare for our shift or how well we do our jobs, that unknown is always there. And that's the perfect time for us to learn more than we've imagined. You know, as a nurse, it's really hard to say that you'll never get caught up with the advances in medical technology and, you know, the better ways to care for our patients. We constantly have to immerse ourselves in literature. We have to be up to date. And that seems stressful thinking about it already, but we must not worry because things are normal. We're not just nurses, we're Wagner nurses. So before I get off my podium here, let me just say, enjoy the rest of the evening with your loved ones because we deserve it 100%. And celebrate the accumulation of knowledge that has prepared us to face that unknown with brave faces and tough hearts. We're going to miss you guys. Congratulations to the Evelyn L. Spiro School of Nursing class of 2016. We did it.
Course and coordinates that theory. And so we want to Since Florence Nightingale is noted, Mother Nursing is noted for using her lamp in Scutari, which is modern-day Turkey. For the country of England, she managed the troops there, and that's where modern nursing started. And epidemiology, we are going to give Professor Gallagher the keeper of the lamp.
And a part of our story that will spark the beginning of many more chapters ahead. The nursing pay we receive from someone that has accompanied us throughout this adventure is so much more than you may think. It is a reminder of the hard work. It is a reminder of the faculty, friends, and family that got us here. It is a reminder of the patients we will help get back on their feet. It is a reminder of the hands we will hold during some of the worst times of that family's life. It is a reminder that we will all be linked together as brothers and sisters of an amazing experience. Most of all, it is a reminder that we are all going to be someone who makes a difference. You have all made a difference in my life, and now it's time to go make a difference in the lives of every single person you meet. So let the light of the lamp guide you for the rest of your future as nurses, and let the pin be a reminder of everything you have learned here at Wagner College. Congratulations again. I wish you nothing but the best, and remember, always and always in kind.
I was curious if Joe in the back could stand and tell us where his original pen is from. Because you will be adding this. Your original pen is from where?
My original pen is from College of Staten Island.
Okay, and so you're going to, Joe is our one Oregon-to-BS student who's graduating here today, and you'll be adding the Wagner pen to that. And thank you so much, Joe, for also attending. And then we also come to get each of you, as we just gave to our previous ceremony graduates, nurse practitioners, we hope to get each of you our Center of Excellence pen as it belongs. So you'll be heavily donned with pens. We'll have to put something extra to wear all of those. So very, very exciting, and congratulations to each and every one of you. I didn't ask them to stand before because some are still coming, such as Professor Gallagher. So I'd like for all of the faculty and staff to stand, and let's salute them for all their contributions. So, before any further ado, I would like to call up the undergraduate director and also your 498 senior pastor professor, Dr. Anne-Marie Dowling, to ask you if you could hand out the pins. And Ed is going to begin playing guitar again. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Victoria Carrillo, the pin my sister.
Thank you.
being pinned by his mother.
Thank you.
Meredith Murphy, being pinned by her mother, who is also a nurse.
Thank you.
Crystal Rivera being pinned by her mother. being pinned by his mother.
One of the great programs, according to the National League of Nurses, has a tremendous heritage of nurse professionals who come through the program and are now major leaders in nursing and healthcare throughout the world. And I know that you've also gotten a wonderful education in civic work. You've met with communities abroad, locally, and dealt with patients and families. And that's what a Wagner education is all about, is to help you become really a dedicated civic professional. I know that's who you are. This program was founded by Dr. Mary Burr, Dean Mary Burr. Her picture hangs in the library. You can walk by and realize it. You can go visit it today or sometime soon. She was the founder of the division to create a school of nursing at Wagner in 1941. And many, as I said, many wonderful professionals have come out of that program. So there's a long history of nursing at Wagner College. It's one of our star programs. One of our wonderful graduates from 1949 was Clara Bacon, who's still with us today and still very much a fan of Wagner College and our nursing program. She went on to become not only one of the major persons in healthcare, nationally and internationally, she was the first woman president of Ivy League University, University of Pennsylvania. And I was visiting with her a while back, and I was saying to her, again, how long this continues to be such a superb program with such superb students who are so dedicated to patients and families and to the highest ethics of healthcare. And she said, of course they are. I graduated from Wagner. They must be. So there's a great tradition to live up to here. I know you will. I know you will distinguish yourselves in the field. I love this program because it's also a strong leadership program. And when I see some of these funny notes that I make along the way, I celebrate the class where that went. And I know many of you, so and I know that this program creates the kind of leadership skills that are so desperately needed, not just healthcare, but throughout the country and the world, where you really learn to bring people together across all the differences of personality, of ethnicity, geography, their expertise. You really learn how to work as a team, get the best out of a team. And you've been doing that in this program, you've been doing it in Wagner learning degrees as well. And that's what you'll be asked to do when you're out in the field. And I know that many, many of you will want to have your own practice. Many of you will go on to get, hope all of you want to get your nurse practitioners designation, and then hopefully beyond that. So congratulations to every one of you, and I just look forward to seeing you as an alumni and seeing you tomorrow at graduation. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Dr. Morales. It means a lot to have both the provost and the president here to offer their support, and they are so behind nursing. We're so unique in that way for a liberal arts college to be so valued. We really are. And we also want to thank so many people who support us, such as the Spiro family, all of them, and we just really appreciate being acknowledged in nursing. So without further ado, and I do want to remind you about the post-baccalaureate DAP that's starting in 2017. Because right now we only take advanced placed nurse practitioners, but 2017, Dr. Abram and Dr. Shirovsky, we're going to be calling them. Okay, if I could have Dr. Denise Gasselberti and Professor Lisa Woody, we are going to start the beautiful Nightingale Pledge with not live candles, because we need a fire marshal for that. But, and we'd like you all to make a program and turn to the Nightingale Pledge. And who is behind the dimming lights back there, because I can't see? Thank you.
Thank you.
And you will be getting the same name that we presented to Professor Gallagher. Take home with you in a box, it has two candles, and it has the Evelyn L. Spiro's pen seal on it, thanks to the office staff and the GAs and Kathy Lippert. So, thank you. As you leave, and we'll have a more round of applause for you as you're leaving. As you leave, you want to go out and down the front steps.